Hello and welcome to On The Sofa. It's that time of the week where we'll be discussing new and upcoming talent. Today we have a range from fashion to music to travel and special guests.
We've searched high and low for all talent. The guests featured in our show today are the young and talented pioneers of tomorrow.
So, to get it started, we have a performance from someone very special indeed. He's been touring the UK, and in other words, he's going to be making his dream a reality. So hey, give a warm welcome to Jamie Bannon.
When the rain is blowing in your face and the whole world is on your case, I could offer you a warm embrace to make you feel my love. When even in shadows and the stars, and there is no one there to dry your tears, I could hold you for a million years to make you feel my love. I know you haven't made your mind up yet, but I will never do you wrong. I've known it from the moment that we met. No doubt in my mind where you belong. I go hungry, I go black and blue. I go crawling down the avenue. No, there's nothing that I would. The storms are raging on the road and sea, and on the highway of regret. The winds of change are blowing wild and free. You ain't seen nothing like me yet. I can make you happy, make your dreams come true. Nothing that I wouldn't do. Go to the ends of the earth for you to make you feel my love. To make you feel my love.
Was amazing. Such talent. This is why we feature upcoming artists. They simply need to be heard.
They do, don't they? I totally agree with you. To kick off today's show, we have Leon, a member from Team Genetic Fashion Brand. Hi, Leon.
Hello.
Hi, Leon. So we have some of the products you guys at Genetics produce, but can you give us a bit of an introduction into what Team Genetics is and what's your role within the company?
Team Genetics is basically a performance wear brand that both me and my partner Joe came up with, and so we're both the co-owners. That's more our roles in the company. We both split the kind of roles between us, where it takes to design the brand. I'll do the, say, the online orders and the website and the social media, whereas he'll go more into more of the designing process of the products, as well as communicating with the manufacturers.
So yeah. What made you specialise in performance wear?
Well, basically, he's, as well as my business partner, he's also my gym partner.
Oh yeah.
So before we came up with the idea, we used to go to the gym every day and kind of we kind of like look around and see the kind of fashion that people were wearing for the gym, and we say how cool it would be to have our own kind of brand and just turn up to the gym in our own brand, see other people there with our clothing on. So yeah, we came up with the idea to kind of make our own.
So it makes you look cooler.
Pretty much, yeah.
Yeah. So did you find it tricky to get the company like started?
Yeah, it's a tricky process. Just the name alone took about 3 weeks. We had lots of different ideas, and then somehow we came up with this, which yeah, we enjoy. As well, but I'd say one of the biggest problems was communicating with the manufacturers, which at first he does now, but at first it was the both of us trying to get the designs together, like all trying to pick the right designs, trying to give that to the manufacturer to produce on a bulk scale for us. That was a bit tricky.
And whereabouts do you see Team Genetics in about 5 years' time, let's say?
About 5 years' time, hopefully. Just have a wide range of products, really. It would be nice to have, you know, a lot of product pages filled with our designs. Like, as you can see now, the women's wear.
Is this the one, the women's wear?
Yeah, this is the women's wear. We got
a tiny women's wear.
Yeah, I think we picked up a small to
not
showcase.
My women's wear, but a small women's wear.
Small women's wear.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, again, different sizes, of course, like all clothing, but these have recently just come in. Hopefully going to supply them online, as well as to this gym that we're paired up with. Partnered up with a gym in Reddish called The Locker. And we're going to supply a lot of our products to them to give it to, like, sell to their customers as such.
So in terms of clothing brands, what kind of other clothing brands would you say, like, inspired the clothes that you make at Genetics?
There was quite a few, actually. There was Machine Fitness, which we were a big fan of, and also Gymshark as well. I think those are the two, I'd say the two very popular brands. They definitely inspired us, and just how successful they were, really. And, you know, we'd love to do that for our entire life, just to have a brand, keep coming up with fresh ideas, be innovative to the kind of, to that kind of thing. But yeah. Yeah.
What kind of advice would you give to young designers who want to get their kickstart their career, let's say, in the clothing industry?
So I'd say the biggest advice I would give to them would be to definitely make sure that if you are going to start it up, it has to be perfect. You can't be slacking off or trying to rush, like take shortcuts, which is we learned that the hard way. We got some joggers in bulk. We got like a sample and then ordered it all, and then of course they didn't do it properly in the bulk. They showed us their best sample, but then they was a bit lazy with it. So you want to be sure that when you're buying your products, it's got to be perfect.
Speaking of ordering the products, where could we order these products to find further information about the Team Genetics wear?
So you can visit our website, www.teamgenetics.co.uk, to kind of see our website. We'll have lots of information on there, as well as where you can actually buy the products.
And so, yeah. Is it just clothing that you see yourself doing more of, or would you do like the gym accessory, like bottles and that kind of stuff?
Oh yeah, definitely. We want to kind of get like the main products in first, you know, like the hoodies, the shirts, the leggings, joggers, and then we kind of go into more of the accessories as well. Hopefully, once we kind of get the main products in, then yeah, we definitely go to the accessories, even caps, you know, yeah. Bottles, things like that. Yeah, no, definitely. Hopefully, that's definitely what we're going to be doing.
And the Do you know the logo? I'm just thinking, doesn't it look a tiny bit like the Netflix logo?
Does a bit.
It's like a bit of a a little bit of a look of it.
Yeah, I think that was the font that some people have actually said that to us. It's not been a problem so far. So far.
I think it's just like, because the letters like we've seen, it's the N-E-T-I-X, and that's a bit like Netflix.
Yeah, no, some people actually thought in the gym when we were wearing it once, they'd come up to us and say, "You're wearing a Netflix shirt." It's like, no, kind of have to pull it down a bit and just kind of bring out the G and the X.
So are you going to like show off then? Are you going to do some press-ups? Because I think we all want to see that.
Yeah, okay.
Go on.
Go for it.
Here we go.
Don't kick it. Oh, damn.
No, I could not do that. I honestly would just lie down.
Do you want to have a go,
Ethan? No, I am not. No, with these twiglets, I don't think so.
Go on, have a go.
No, I am not.
Well done. There's more than what we could do.
Well done.
So it's great.
Okay.
Look better if you were wearing that, if you could get it on.
So.
Definitely.
But thank you so much for coming.
Thank you very much for being on the show, Leon. We wish you all the best with Team Genetics and your team and for your company. So join us back after this break when we'll be having the producer of Fly Music, Cameron Wilson.
Carrot Sun comes in 7 different scents, perfect for your skin type with the option of a spray or a cream. Tan accelerators for a deeper, darker, faster, natural tan.
Hello and welcome, and you're back with us in the studio. So we're here joined with Cam Wilson.
Hello.
Hi.
So Cam, tell us about Fly Music and why you decided to create the company.
So Fly Music, it's a mixture of a freelance company basing music around Manchester. So the reason I kind of made it is because when I was growing up, I used to listen to bands like New Order, Oasis, The Stone Roses, like that type of style, that genre, like, I wouldn't say genre, but just the area of Manchester, the music was quite good. And recently, in the last few years, the music scene in Manchester has dipped quite a lot, like breaking up with Oasis and stuff. Just nothing's really been brought up. And like, I just feel like with Fly Music as a possibility of bringing those Manchester bands and putting them back up where they were supposed to be.
No, I really like this logo. It's got a groovy look, hasn't it? So what was the whole kind of inspiration and aim for this, and who even designed it? I love it.
Like, it isn't really, we didn't really have any inspiration for the logo, because we had the name Flies, kind of bold, kind of in your face, and we decided we need something bold and just something that would catch people's eyes, and I just pulled over my friend saying, hey, can you make us a logo? And he made this, and I feel like it's really, like, kind of, like, you can imagine it on, like, a side of, like, an album or an LP or something, and that's kind of what we were going for. It was just something on their minds.
Where did your inspiration for music production start?
So, the inspiration for music production, I was just always inspired by music, had quite a massive interest in music, and then I was like, you know what, I need to learn how to make it so then I can go bring out my own, because that's probably one of the best feelings, making something and putting it as your own. And only recently I've been just been messing around with stuff on softwares and all sorts, and I've been kind of just uploading it so-and-so-and-so, and then it's coming to the point now where I want to start bringing and recording bands in and promoting them, and then it's just that kind of cycle, record, send, share, etc.
And if you could produce a piece of music with any musician or band, who would that be?
So, like, that's a bit of a weird question, but personally, just in general, from the Manchester point of view, I know, a band called Blossoms, who are doing really well recently. I'd love to get and mess around with some of them, and it depends on the act, because there's a mix of if you're mixing an acoustic album, you only really have to focus on vocals, guitar, that's it, whereas let's say you get in a band, you have to focus on many things, so mixing and producing, it kind of just depends on who it is, but it's mainly I just like to do band work, so any indie band most likely. So that's probably my favorite.
So do you have a favourite radio channel that you listen to, or anything that you like, and why?
So, because I'm massively into alt rock, indie rock, all that. I really like Radio X. Not really a big fan of Chris Moyles, but still, he's really good. The music played, in my opinion, is really good, and sometimes the humour is quite well. It's meant to get the indie market, so I feel like it works really well in that retrospect.
And coming back to Fly Music, where do you see that in 5 years?
So with Fly, hopefully in 5 odd years, we'll be able to have released albums, maybe have an album released in HMV or some store, and maybe just looking back and kind of, it's just trying to get it recognised. And I feel like if we get it recognised, we're pretty much done. And even if we don't get recognised and a band that from the label is quite recognised, then it's all good. I just feel it would be really good just to have our name on something, to be honest. It's about it.
And lastly, what advice would you give to people like yourself if they want to get into, producing music and learn more about it?
So what I'd say if you wanted to get into music production is just kind of just have a mess around with stuff. You can just get free softwares now. You can get, if you buy an Apple product, you get GarageBand for free. So you can just put your voice over something and make just simple loops, and you can just have a bit of a mess about. I didn't really have a set way of going through things. I just decide, hey, this sounds good, add this effect, add that effect, and then just mess around, and that's pretty much how I feel it'll do well.
And I mean back to my logo, I just love this logo. Is there any meaning behind the arrow, because arrows do have a lot of significance?
You'd have to ask my graphic designer about that. But just in general, I think Fly arrows go to the air and stuff, depending on the angle, obviously. But it just adds into the bold style of the actual logo. Then again, it's really in your face, especially with the arrow.
Well, it's quite clever. It's a really good logo. And thank you for being on the show, Cam.
You're right.
We wish you and Fly Music the best of luck. And coming up after today's top 10, we have two brave members from the audience who have volunteered to do the Cinnamon Challenge. So we will see how that goes in a short while.
For now, we have the top 10 adventures you need to go on. Thank you.
Do we need this?
Are we back on? I think we're back on, so if we are, just like to say hello and welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. So here we have Alex Hardman and here we have Charlie Pearson.
These two unlucky fellows will battle it out to see who can keep the powder in their mouth before bursting. But before we watch this epic battle, here is Glazell's version of the Cinnamon Challenge.
Do the cinnamon challenge. The cinnamon is good for you. You put cinnamon on, like, you know, different drinks and stuff.
Now do the cinnamon challenge.
Really? What's so challenging about cinnamon? So everybody's been getting on my nerves. I got some cinnamon. I don't even know what kind you're supposed to get. So you take some cinnamon. I guess. I don't. So I have a spoon, and I'm spooning this. So I had this, because I don't know how much you're supposed to take, so. Just take it, and I guess you count to 10, or you take it, and I don't know. All right, so here's the cinnamon, all right?
Let's go.
I love cinnamon meat. I know that sounds crazy, so I can't imagine this being too difficult.
It's good for the metabolism.
It is actually. So technically, this is a healthy thing to do.
This is gonna make me hate.
Anyway.
Put cinnamon in anything. It's gonna make me hate it.
It'll yeah. Be fun to watch then.
So I'm gonna give you a countdown when you're ready, fellas. Are you ready? Okay.
Actually, wait. Palm down.
Pause it.
We don't want to get into it too yet. We don't want to get into it right now because. Mean.
So stop, wait. What are you expecting? What are you nervous? How are you feeling?
I've done this before, so I know exactly.
You've done it before?
Yeah.
And that's how did that go?
Oh, I don't know. It hurt.
Why? Is it like spicy?
Yeah. Like it'll hit the back of your throat and it's like you've got like a gas cloud wanna come out your mouth.
No, I'm glad we're not doing it. I'm so glad.
It's been ages since I've done it, so I'm probably forgot how it is.
Yeah. So I mean, it's like it's festive, isn't it, as well? It's December time, everyone, so it's a festive thing to do.
It's festive when it's in hot chocolate.
Exactly.
Not when it's just in a spoon.
Well, let's make it festive, then.
Yeah. Right, should we go for it?
Yep. Should we go for it?
Right, I'll give you a countdown, okay? You ready? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh, oh no.
I'm so stoked.
I can feel it in my mouth and I've not even had some.
Just spit it out.
They're going for it.
Someone's gonna crack. Oh. I can't.
Do you know, I never used to like cinnamon and I didn't like olives either, but I do now, so that's why I'm putting them off. And mustard as well.
Just spit it out. Ew.
Oh, do you know I can? Why can I feel it in my mouth?
Just spit it out. You know you want to. You're dying.
I'm gagging. I'm dipping. This is making me feel sick. I'm gonna. Oh.
Not on the mic, Charlie.
Oh, I can. Oh.
Just go on. There. Go on. on, let it out.
They're actually not. I'm going to be sick. Mm. Not going to lie. Thank God we put what is it? Bin bag down here.
Don't look at me. Look away.
That was like a bit of a smoke cloud.
Charlie vapes.
Vaping cinnamon. I can smell it. It's like being at Christmas markets, isn't it? Do you know, like when you walk past and you're like cinnamon and then it's a sausage and then it's a mushroom and there's just all these scents in your nostrils?
Yeah, but it's not the scents of people with cinnamon in their mouths.
That's true. Like all the saliva. No, I'm going to be sick.
Are you going to spit out?
That is something I don't want to see.
No, don't add the spit.
Okay, you don't want to see what is in this bucket, guys. It's horrible.
Ew. Ew. Okay.
This is like medieval sound effects and stuff. So, tell us, how was that? Ew! I hope you can't hear this. This is horrible sound.
Like, oh, that is right.
It's like sand. But
how
like
was that then? How was it? What did it taste like?
So
other
dry.
Than cinnamon.
It's so dry.
Really?
Yeah.
Would you like some more water? Okay, can we have some more water?
This is Rachel the runner. She's being our very own special. Ew, Charlie, that's disgusting.
I mean, this is like a ball of it.
No,
like a ball of it.
No, Charlie, stop. Don't look at, no.
I'm not looking, I won't look, and I don't need to see that.
I've seen stuff like that come out. I thought it'd come out, in a massive...
Yeah, like, I thought you were just going to, like, instantly, like, put it in your mouth and just, like...
It was
like
all in the front of my teeth, between the...
Yeah.
Under your tongue.
I'm not going to lie.
It just congeals.
I kind of know the feeling, because I was a bit of a wuss, so I didn't decide to do it with cinnamon, I did it with cocoa. I was like, Mum, I've just got... just get me some Nesquik.
That doesn't count, Ethan.
It didn't, because it tasted quite nice, actually.
Oh.
That's just a piece of purpose.
Is your throat burning? Is your throat burning?
I mean, you can have a go if you want.
But no, we don't have cinnamon, do we?
Come on, who wants to see them do it?
Get some spare cinnamon.
I'm not.
Come on, get cinnamon.
No.
No, we're not. No. Why are you making me do this?
Come on, Ethan.
Oh, no. I'm nervous.
I'm not doing that.
Jess, you've got to.
I'll do it again.
No, Jess has got to do it. You two have done it. Right, you ready?
Wait, has Charlie had his mouth on that cup?
Can you give us a countdown? We give you a countdown.
I'm allergic.
Okay, how about five?
I want some water first.
Three, two, one.
Oh, I don't like it.
Okay, well, I'm glad you were watching the days on the sofa. Check out the guest we had on our show. And that's it.
I feel like I'm at the dentist, God's sake. I really don't like this.
It's horrible.
You've got it on your top.
It's horrible.
So
guys, how was it?
I'm gonna be sat on the 50 bus going home, stinking cinnamon. Well, thank you very much for joining the show.
When the guests
don't try this at home. Can't breathe.
When the guests do better than the actual.
See you later, everyone.